Joining me today, 104.5 The Team, 104.5theteam.com, is Marshall Kellner, broadcaster for the Dunedin Blue Jays, the single-A affiliate in the Florida State League of the Toronto Blue Jays, talking about Jeff Hoffman, Shaker graduate, number 9 pick in last year's MLB draft. Marshall, how are you?
I'm good, Brady. How are you?
Good. So Hoffman, he gets the ball the other day. He gets the loss. He goes 5 innings, only allows 2 earned runs, though. He's 2-3 on the season. What are your impressions of him? Is he still looking good to you, or should he be developing a little quicker here? Are you surprised at his numbers?
No, he's looking very good. The two earned runs that he gave up came in one inning. With one out, he gave up a jam shot, a little bloop single to right field to a right-handed batter. And then the next batter hit a chopper that happened to go over the head of the first baseman and landed just fair inside the line for a double. So those were the two hits in the inning, and then the run scored on a grounder with the infield back and a wild pitch that maybe should have been caught by the catcher. It was a little bit high, and he had to leap up for it, went off of his glove. So those are how the two runs scored. Other than that, he was pretty flawless. The fastball command keeps on getting better from him, and the curveball, when he's able to throw it for strikes, and he's able to use it as a chase pitch as well. So, I think he just keeps getting a little bit better and better each start. You can see he's very confident out there. I don't think that's an issue. And I think he keeps progressing. It's pretty impressive coming off of Tommy John, what he's been able to do. They're still pretty cautious with his pitch count. He doesn't go that deep yet, but he has pitched into the sixth inning a couple of times, gone 5 2/3, and had opportunities to finish sixth. Really, when he's given up runs in any start, they've all come in one inning for the most part. When he does give up runs, most of his start is clean aside from that one inning. So, I've been impressed so far, and I think he's just moving in the right direction.
I want to ask you about this pitch count. What is it on a nightly basis for him on a start-to-start basis? He has gone only more than 5 full innings twice, and the other 2 outings were 5 2/3. Is it a hard and fast pitch count? Because, look, we're going to get to this in a minute. He's not striking out a ton of guys. He's not walking a ton of guys. So it seems to me from the outside like his pitch count per inning would be relatively low, but is there a reason why he's not allowed to get out of the sixth inning on all occasions?
Well, I think just coming on, it's got to be twofold, and this is just my thinking on it. I haven't confirmed this, but I think it's twofold. One, it's his first professional season, and he's a high draft pick, so they're going to be cautious with him. They're going to protect that arm. They have a lot invested in him for good reason. And then number two, he's coming off of Tommy John surgery, and they don't want to put too many innings, I don't think, on that arm this early in his career and the year right after that surgery. I think those are really the two main reasons. It's not because he's been ineffective. They've given him an opportunity to finish sixth a couple of times. And I think as the season goes along, you might see him extended a little bit more, but not much. I don't think they're going to push him out to 100 pitches or anything. Not quite yet.
Are they capping him at like 75 pitches or something? I'm curious. Is he hitting, the 90 pitch mark in the fifth inning, which would be a concern that your innings are taking too long? Or does he have good, efficient innings and they are just pulling him really before they would need to from a performance standpoint?
Yeah, no, definitely from a performance standpoint, he could go deeper. It's just, and it's not that he has 90 after 5. He's maybe had 1 or 2 outings where the pitch count has gotten elevated. But no, I think a couple outings ago was maybe his best when he went 5 2/3 and got a bunch of ground balls. They were just pounding it into the ground. That was back in Dunedin. And then this outing against Daytona, like I said, they scored 2 runs on a couple of pretty cheap hits. No, I don't think they're pulling him because of performance issues. I think they just want to protect that arm.
Hoffman is a guy who's 95 to 99 miles an hour routinely with great secondary stuff. he has swing and miss stuff. He only has 32 strikeouts and 49 in the third innings this season. Is that a concern? We had talked earlier, after his first few starts, he was struggling to put guys away. Is he truly just maturing as a pitcher and going with the mentality of, hey, I'm going to let him hit it and let my defense work behind me? Or should he be getting more swings and misses and more strikeouts?
I think the only time he struggles to put hitters away is if he leaves the fastball up in the zone and then they're able to foul off several pitches. But he's been keeping the fastball down better. He did have 6 strikeouts, which was a career high a couple of times ago. I'm not too worried about it. I think a lot of hitters have the perception, against a pitcher like that with the stuff he has, I've got to go up here swinging early in the count, and then they might pound a ground ball, pound something into the ground early in the count, and then he doesn't even get the opportunity to strike somebody out. So I think those will continue to come as the fastball command continues to improve. He'll be able to get ahead in the count more and then use that that wipeout 12-6 curveball.
Alex Anthopoulos, the Blue Jays GM, said recently, within the last 2 weeks or so, that he really felt no rush in promoting Jeff Hoffman, despite the fact that he has looked good down in Dunedin. Do you anticipate, again, just your opinion, speculation, do you think he's a guy that's going to end the season in Double A, or do you think he'll be at Dunedin for the duration?
I wouldn't be surprised either way, Brady, and again, this is just me guessing. I don't see any rush. They're treating him just like any other player, and he has said this in another interview. He said, when I dominate this level, then I'll move on to the next level, and so on and so on. So, no, I don't think there's any rush. Like I said, first professional season coming off of Tommy John. Yes, a lot of Blue Jays fans, want to see him, rise through the system as quickly as possible, and that's understandable. He's the 9th overall draft pick, but they also want to be smart about it and promote him when he's ready. And I think he could do well at the Double A level, no question. But they'll promote him when they think it's the right time. And like I said, I wouldn't be shocked either way.
A Capital Region native who was in Dunedin and did now get to call it to Double A is Murphy Smith. Won his first start for the New Hampshire Fisher Cats in Double A earlier this week. Murphy Smith on the opposite end of the spectrum as Jeff Hoffman, a 2006 high school graduate out of Shenandoah, had been released by Oakland in spring training, really found a niche with the Blue Jays system early on this season, right, Marshall, and eventually earned that promotion. What did you see from Murphy?
No question. He came in with a phenomenal attitude. You're in Double A for 3 seasons, and then you get released, a year where you thought, you might start the year in Triple A, and, you could see him maybe coming in with a sour attitude. Not the case at all. I mean, he had a phenomenal attitude from day one. He said, my opportunity is kind of dried up with Oakland, and, I'm just taking this as a new opportunity. This is kind of like a new lease on life for me. And he's got better and better as the season went along and actually became probably our most consistent starter. He was the pitcher of the week for a couple weeks, week stretch in June where he threw a complete game, 7-inning shutout in game 2 of a doubleheader with 11 Ks, and then he went 7 shutout in another outing. And in June, he had an ERA of under 2. So there's no question that you just look at the numbers that he deserved that promotion, and then you look at his performance. He's just you can tell he's a veteran pitcher, and he knows how to pitch. And I know that sounds cliche, but he's able to get ahead in the count. He's able to keep hitters off balance, and he deserved the chance to take it to the next level. And I know Oakland tried to move him to the bullpen last year, and now he's back in the starting role with the Blue Jays organization. So I think he's excited about that. And he won his first start at Double A, which was good to see.
Rumor has it, reports surfaced, that he hit 95 miles an hour in that start as well. So he's always had the great curveball. People from around here know it. A good changeup. He's developed a cutter in the last few years, and he's got the velocity to go with it. So we wish Murphy Smith the best of luck with the New Hampshire Fisher Cats in his quest to get to the big leagues. Marshall Kellner, Dunedin Blue Jays broadcaster, with us here at 104.5theteam.com. Marshall, it's a long season for you, and it's going to keep going. We'll talk to you again here soon.
Sounds good, Brady. Appreciate it.